This is the garden of the house that I rent here in the New Forest. It's a place that's very close to my heart. I've grown up here and I very much love the ecology of this area. Particularly where my home, you know, I've got tawny owls roosting behind the barn. I feed foxes and badgers in the garden. But these animals are just the tip of an iceberg, the very tip of an extraordinary community. And what I'm really interested in today is looking at the more fundamental building blocks of that community, and they don't come any more fundamental than the soil. And I'm going to have the opportunity to look into this soil with a degree of detail that I could never have dreamt of when I was first understanding tawny owls, badgers and foxes. Because we're going to be able to take samples from this soil and look at the DNA of all of the creatures that live in it, particular to this very area. And that, for me, is tremendously exciting, because without all of these creatures, you couldn't have everything else. Here we are, here's the last sample. And true to scientific practice, this is now going to be rushed off to the lab. But what's going to happen to it is quite unique, because we're going to be sequencing the DNA of all of the organisms that live in here. And that's why we call it metagenomics. And the applied application of this is just profound, because if you know exactly what's living in the soil, then you can know exactly what's best to put into it, what's best to plant in it.
Now, we received samples from Chris Packham's garden, from different places, different sites in the garden. Now, what we want to do is to sequence directly those samples, obtain information about the species, organisms that are really alive in that soil. To sequence these samples, we're going to use Illumina technology. That was a technology developed in the UK. These technologies are new. We couldn't have done this 10, 15 years ago. In order to be able to sequence the samples before, we had to culture the organisms there. Many organisms cannot be cultured. We can do today with these technologies, go directly to the environment, pick the samples, put them in the machines, and get the information straight away.
We've analyzed around 200 million pieces of DNA. And in 5 out of the 6 samples, around 70 to 80% of the bacteria just come from 2 phyla. And those are bacteria that tend to be associated with the roots of plants and also breaking down organic matter in the soil. In one sample, the woodland sample, we do see a difference. And that's in the proportion of bacteria that seem to be associated with acid soil. And it's known that some types of woodland do have, are associated with certain types of acid soil. So that may be characteristic of the woodland from which this sample was taken.
These results strike me as remarkable. When you think about it, it costs hundreds of millions of dollars to sequence the first human genome. And now, in a couple of weeks, by using next generation sequencing, we can identify all of the microorganisms living in this soil. And the applications of this technology are simply profound. When you think about it, farmers can make precise choices about the crops they put into their soil. Food security, it goes on and on. And one thing's for sure, this technology is set to expand and improve. That is really exciting.